Today we're talking about the Israeli parliament. I know, the jokes really just write themselves on this one. Recently they accomplished what Iran has been trying to do for years. Take down the Israeli government. Okay, that might be the most clickbaity way of putting it, but this is uncharted territory for the country. For the first time in Israel's history, they're being forced to hold a second round of elections, because no out-and-out leader emerged from the first round of voting. Now, I know that sentence makes no sense based on what we as Americans know about democracies, but stick with me, because as you can probably guess, things are about to get interesting.
The state of Israel will have to have an unprecedented second election this year. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu failed in his efforts to form a coalition government by tonight's deadline.
Woohoo! More voting, said the guy in charge of making campaign ads and precisely nobody else. First, how could this happen? I mean, it's an election. Somebody won, right? Well, democracies are like snowflakes. They're all different and beautiful in their own ways. While America has a democracy designed for movies, we vote and then immediately and dramatically we see who our leader is, most European countries and Israel have a more reality TV show inspired democracy. And let me tell you, Mark Burnett could not have done much better if he was writing a constitution. In Israel, you vote for a party and the seats in parliament are handed out based on what percentage of the vote each party gets. Problem is, barely ever does one party get 50% of the votes, so you have to go to round 2 of the reality TV show. We've distributed the power through voting, now you have to form alliances with other parties to get it so that overall your voting coalition controls over half of parliament, or in the case of Israel, 61 seats at the Knesset. The guy whose team gets over half the votes will be the next Israeli prime minister. Wow, that certainly beats the opportunity of launching your own failed singing career. So here's the result of the most recent election. We saw Netanyahu's party get 36 seats, and his second place competitor get 35 seats. So all Netanyahu needed was 25 other people to sign on. Unfortunately, no immunity idols here.
His conservative Likud party had made a strong showing in last month's initial election, but Netanyahu could not assemble a majority in parliament.
Yes, when the first round of elections happens, it triggers a 6-week clock, at which time if nobody has over 60 seats, well then Israel does what any non-tech-savvy person does. Have you tried restarting it? Generally that fixes the problem. Now before we get into what's next, I'm just going to indulge myself a little bit and talk about what happened over the last 6 weeks. Because for the first time in history, the old white guy insisting that this has never happened before is actually telling the truth. This came down to a struggle between two blocks of his potential right-wing coalition partners, the secular ultra-nationalists and the ultra-orthodox factions, who refused to compromise on proposed legislation on military service. Man, good luck compromising with any party that has ultra in their name. Here's the tragedy of the situation for Netanyahu though. So you have Netanyahu up there with 36 seats. He's got two ultra-orthodox parties signed on who share 15 seats. That brings us to 51 seats. Then you have the hawkish United Right signed on because if you're actively against Palestine, well, you're alright with them. Their 5 seats brings us to 56 seats. Lastly, you have the center-right, mostly economic party, and Israel's economy has been doing surprisingly well under Netanyahu, so he has their support. With their seat, we're at 60. And how many seats do you need to run the government? Oh yeah, 61. One more seat. That's all you need. So this leads us to the last man Netanyahu might be able to get support from.
Standing in his way, Avigdor Lieberman. His ultra-nationalist secular party controls 5 seats, and the former defense minister wants something in return for their support. The guarantee that ultra-Orthodox Jews will no longer be exempt from military service, a huge problem for Netanyahu's other ultra-Orthodox allies.
That's right, politicians shot themselves in the foot for the army. Well, that was the main reason, but also remember that this was a secular ultra-nationalist party. And they seemed to be looking around and saying, you know, even for Israel, this coalition's getting pretty Jewish. He recently said a government of 60 is not a right-wing government, but an ultra-Orthodox government that instead of preserving Israel as a Jewish state, will change it into a theocracy. Not to be a dick, but whoo boy, good luck with this next snap election coming up, bud. Things got so bad that Netanyahu even approached Labor, the center-left stalwart, which rebuffed his advance. Now that might not sound crazy, but that would be like Trump approaching Biden to join his coalition. He just needed one more seat though. Anyways, this brings us to today and... ooh, time's up. I'm sorry to say you don't have enough chairs to proceed to the next round. Can we bring up the next level of participants?
For the first time ever, a general election in Israel failed to produce a government. Now the country has to hold new elections in late summer. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu failed to form a government from the parties elected to Israel's parliament.
Yes, the new Israeli elections are scheduled to happen on September 17th. What happens until then? Well, in a real whoo-wee, do I feel sorry for the people who just betrayed Netanyahu's situation. Because he is currently the Prime Minister, Mr. Netanyahu will now remain in power until September's vote. That's pretty much everything you need to know about the situation over there. Boy, short episode. Hey, they don't all have to be Ken Burns documentaries. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the left of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.